Hi all, welcome to PowerShell for Penetration Testers at Pentester Academy. I am Nikhil Mittal, your instructor for this course. In this video, let's go through the course content and what is coming up in this course. First of all, couple of things about me. I am a speaker and a trainer. I have spoken at DEFCON, Black Hat Europe, Black Hat US, Abu Dhabi, Troopers, DeepSec, and few more conferences. I am the creator of Kautilya and Nishang, two open source toolkits for penetration testers. Kautilya is a toolkit which helps in usage of human interface devices during penetration tests. And Nishang is a tool which allows for usage of PowerShell in offensive security and penetration testing. We will see both of these in this course. While Kautilya would be used rarely, Nishang would be used much when we discuss about different penetration testing techniques and PowerShell. Also, I'm a freelancer hacker or penetration tester, wherein I do penetration tests for my clients on contract basis. I'm mostly interested in new and innovative ways of breaking into a computer or a network for penetration testing. Now let's move on to the course contents. The course will move ahead this way. We will have an introduction to PowerShell, why we are using a shell and scripting language based on Windows, how it aids us in penetration tests, to what things it allows us access in a Windows network, etc. Then we will move on to basics of PowerShell. We will see how to use commands, commandlets, variables, functions, condition statements, loop statements, etc. Then the course moves on to scripting part. There we will see how to use the ISE to write scripts in PowerShell, how to execute those scripts, what are the peculiarities associated with all these things. We will see what execution policies are. We will go through pipelines, different kind of operators, functions, advanced functions, etc. Then we move on to the advanced scripting concepts, wherein we discuss functions with dynamic parameters, how to pass arguments to scripts, how to write scripts like commandlets, etc. Then we move on to modules, where we learn how to create and use modules in PowerShell. Then jobs and remoting in PowerShell is discussed. We discuss how PowerShell remoting is useful in a penetration test, how to use it, how to implement, how it is implemented, etc. Then we move on to PowerShell with .NET, where we see how to extend the functionality of PowerShell with the help of .NET, how to use .NET code and classes and assemblies, etc. in your PowerShell code. Then we move on to using Windows API with PowerShell. After that, PowerShell and WMI is discussed. After that, how to work with COM objects, how to create instances of applications on Windows, and then interaction with the registry is discussed. Once we go through these language basics, we move on to the penetration testing part, where we go through all the phases of penetration test. We will see how to do recon and scanning using PowerShell. Then we move on to the exploitation part, how to use brute force attacks, client-side attacks, how to use existing exploitation techniques and improve those with PowerShell. Then we'll see how to port and when to port exploits to PowerShell. Is it necessary? If yes, how do we do it? And then we see how to use PowerShell with a human interface device. Then we move on to using PowerShell with Metasploit, how to run PowerShell scripts in Metasploit. Then using PowerShell in Metasploit exploits. Then you move on to one of the most important parts in a penetration test, post-exploitation. We see how to do information gathering and exfiltration. We'll see and write backdoors in PowerShell. We'll see how to do privilege escalation. We will gather and dump system secrets. Continuing with the post-exploitation, we'll see how to pass or reuse hashes and credentials. And then we will come back to PowerShell remoting. Then WMI and WSMN for command and script execution. We will see web shells. We will see how to achieve persistence, like reboot persistence or process persistence, etc. Then we will see how to use PowerShell with other security tools. Most of these would be open source. And finally, we will see how to defend against PowerShell attacks. All these topic heads would be accompanied by exercises, code discussion, and hands-on. So that is all for this video. If you are enjoying your time at Pentester Academy, please recommend us to your friends and colleagues in the information security community.